Hey, yeah, and welcome to another episode of .NET MAUI 101. In this episode, we're going to talk about data triggers, which allow you to set properties on your control based on a data bound value. What that's all about, let's go check it out. Welcome back to another episode of .NET MAUI 101. I'm your host, Gerald, and in this episode, we're going to talk about data triggers. Now, in another video, I already talked about property triggers. There are multiple types of triggers, data triggers, property triggers, event triggers. You're going to see all of them on this channel, so make sure you're subscribed. And with property triggers, what you can do is change the appearance or even trigger actions based on a property of a control. Now, in this video, we're going to see how to do that same thing, but now based on values that you can data bind from your code behind, basically. So whenever a value changes in your code behind, whenever you have a count value in your view model, then you can change the appearance or the maybe if something is enabled of your button, your control, without having to actually reference your control and do that thing. So it sounds a little bit cryptic. Let's just dive into the code and see how all of this works. Here in Visual Studio 2022, I created a file new .NET MAUI project, and I already prepared some things for you. I already implemented a data trigger so that you can see how it works. So this is just the file new project. So you can see the differences here. You can spot that very easily, and I will walk you through what I've changed. So here we have this button. So you have this counter button that will increment whenever you click it, right? So that's all there. But now I added this button triggers, right? So you have this button dot triggers, and in here you can have this data trigger, you can have a property trigger, you can have a multi-trigger. Again, there are multiple types of triggers. But now I have this data trigger, and you're going to have to say, hey, this target type for this trigger is going to be a button, right? So you're going to have to let it know that this is a button. That's mostly for the setter right here so that it knows which properties it can apply here. Then we are going to set the binding, and this is binding to a count. I'll get to that in a minute. And then whenever the count, in my case, this is an int value, is going to be 10, then it's going to apply whatever is in here. So it's going to apply this setter with is enabled false. So it's going to disable the button whenever the counter goes to 10. Now I can also do multiple things. I can add multiple setters in here. So you can also do things with the background color if that's what you want, or basically any property that is on the button you can influence through this thing. So now the binding, again, this video is too short to go over all of data binding as well. But here we have, I've changed a little bit that this is a property now. So I have this count property, which notifies the UI that property has changed. So this is very much data binding 101. I set the binding context so that I mimic kind of like, hey, I have this view model instead of just having this field, right? That's important that you have this property and all the data binding ingredients are here. So don't worry about it too much. You should have that. This is about the data triggers. So whenever I have all of this in place, I can now run this on, well, any platform that is supported by .NET MAUI. So we're going to see it on Android right here, but it also works, of course, on Windows, iOS, macOS, all the things, because this doesn't really have to do with the platform, but this is really the abstract layer that .NET MAUI adds. So whenever I start clicking here on the button and I get to 10, you can see that it now disables, right? It becomes gray and I cannot increment it any further. So that is with the data trigger right here. I don't have to specify this counter button dot is enabled whenever the count becomes 10, I can just solve this with all XAML right here and basically no code involved other than the data binding that I already have. Now, doing this for all buttons can become a little verbose, right? So what I can also do is disable this one. I'll put this in a comment and go up here. And I also have this here in a style. So if I uncomment this one, I have it in a style right here, and this style applies to a button. So it says target type button. If you want to use the explicit styles, you have to do an X key here, and you have to my button style, and then you have to, I know there's a typo in there, but I'm not going to fix it. And you on this button have to do style is my button style, but then with the typo as well, right? So that it matches. So now it will use that style, but I'm just going to use it on any button because I only have one anyway. So I'm going to remove this one. And if you don't do this, it's an implicit style and it will be applied to all the buttons. So now I have the same thing. I basically can copy and paste whatever I had there. You can see the syntax highlighting is a little bit weird. This is a current bug in Visual Studio, the version that I have. But you can see the same things, target type button, binding is count, value is 10, setter is enabled is false, but now I also do the background color will become red, right? So that's the extra thing that we're going to see. You can add multiple setters in here. So if I run this again, it will now use it through this style, which makes it much more reusable, and I don't have to do this on all my buttons. And whenever I do the same thing now, it will disable the button and it will show the red background so that you can see that it goes through this style, and now it will work for all the buttons, right? So that's how you can easily reuse this in your XAML and make that less verbose. That's how you use data triggers in .NET MAUI. That makes it all clear, right? And this is such powerful stuff. The example that I have here can be used for validation, right? So you can also do it for the entry, whenever the entry value that is data bind to your entry, whenever that property is empty, you're going to disable the button. And now you suddenly have your first form validation going on for .NET MAUI, right? So this is such powerful stuff. All the triggers, the property triggers, data triggers, and there is much more. Speaking of which, we actually have event triggers as well. So go check out the video that is popping up on your corner on event triggers, and I'll be seeing you for that one.